Hello students, welcome back to our channel. Let us discuss few important problems in this video based on the concept integration by substitution method. See here, these are the four important questions which are asked in previous board exams. Watch this video till the end to understand all these problems. Let's begin our class with the first problem. See here, first question. Evaluate integral 2 cos x by 3 sin square x dx. Let us discuss solution of this one. Given integral is equal to integral 2 cos x by 3 sin square x dx. In the given integrand, we have a constant term on numerator 2 and on denominator 3. So by using basic properties of indefinite integrals, the constant 2 by 3 we can write outside of integral. And in the given integrand, we have two trigonometric functions, on numerator cos x and on denominator sin square x. So now I am going to take the combination cos x by sin x and another one 1 by sin x. That means the integrand I am going to write cos x by sin x into 1 by sin x. Then what we will get the new step? See here, 2 by 3 into integral cos x by sin x into 1 by sin x dx. By using basics of trigonometry, cos x by sin x can be written as cot x and 1 by sin x can be written as cosecant x. Then the next step is 2 by 3 into integral cosecant x into cot x dx. Now the given integral reduces to a known form. We know the standard integral formula, integral cosecant x into cot x dx. So by using this standard integral formula, what we will get the next step? See here, 2 by 3 into minus cosecant x plus c. If we simplify this, the final answer is minus 2 by 3 into cosecant x plus c. This is the final answer for the given integral. I hope you understand. Let us discuss one more problem. See here, evaluate integral secant square 7 minus 4x dx. Let us discuss solution of this one. Given integral is equal to integral secant square 7 minus 4x dx. Now substitute some part of integrand as another variable such that its differentiation exists in the integral. So if you observe the given integrand, the angle of secant square term is 7 minus 4x. The derivative of 7 minus 4x is a constant. That's why I am considering the term 7 minus 4x as a new variable. So put 7 minus 4x is equal to t. Differentiate this one with respect to x. Then the derivative of 7 minus 4x is minus 4. And the derivative of t with respect to x is dt by dx. So the next step is minus 4 into 1 is equal to dt by dx. If we cross multiply, the next step is dx is equal to dt by minus 4. Now if we substitute this equation and this equation in the given integral, then what we will get the new step? See here, integral secant square t into dt by minus 4. How we got this one? 7 minus 4x is the new variable t and dx value is dt by minus 4. That's why we got this term. In this integrand, we have a constant minus 1 by 4. By using basic properties of indefinite integrals, the constant we can write outside of integral. Then the new step is minus 4 into integral secant square t dt. If we observe this integral, it is clearly in the standard form. So what is the standard form? Integral secant square x dx. So we know the standard integral formula. By using this standard integral formula, what we will get the next step? See here, minus 1 by 4 into tan t plus c. Now replace the new variable by the original variable in the answer. So what is the new variable here? T. What is the original variable function? 7 minus 4x. So if we substitute t is equal to 7 minus 4x, then we will get the final answer. See here, what is the final answer? Minus 1 by 4 into tan of 7 minus 4x plus c. So this is the final answer for the given integral. I hope you understand. Let us discuss one more problem. See here, evaluate integral log x by x dx. Let us discuss solution of this one. Given integral is equal to integral log x by x dx. In the given integrand, we have two terms, log x and 1 by x. So I am going to separate log x from the numerator and the remaining term 1 by x I am going to separate. Then what you will get the new step? See here, integral log x into 1 by x dx. Now substitute some part of integrand as another variable such that its differentiation exists in the integral. If you observe the integrand, the derivative of the function log x is 1 by x. That's why I am considering the function log x as a new variable t. So put log x is equal to t. Differentiate this one with respect to x. Then the derivative of log x is 1 by x and the derivative of t with respect to x is dt by dx. So the next step is 1 by x is equal to dt by dx. If we cross multiply, the new step is 1 by x dx is equal to dt. If we substitute this equation and this equation in the integral, what we will get? See here in the next step, integral t dt. Why? Because log x we considered as a new variable t and 1 by x dx we got dt. That's why we got this step. If we observe this integral, it is clearly in the form of integral x power n dx. So we know the standard integral formula, integral x power n dx. By using this standard integral formula, what we will get the next step? See here, t square by 2 plus c. Now replace the new variable by the original variable in the answer. So what is the new variable here? T. What is the original variable function? Log x. So if we substitute t is equal to log x, we will get the final answer. See here, what is the final answer? 1 by 2 into log x whole square plus c. So this is the final answer for the given integral. I hope you understand. Let us discuss one more problem. And this is the last problem in this video. See here, evaluate integral log modulus of sin x by tan x dx. Let us discuss solution of this one. Given integral is equal to integral log modulus of sin x by tan x dx. If you observe, in the given integrand we have two terms, log modulus of sin x on numerator and tan x on denominator. Out of these two terms, I am going to take log modulus of sin x one combination and the remaining 1 by tan x function as the another combination. Then what we will get the new step? See here, integral log modulus of sin x into 1 by tan x dx. Now substitute some part of integrand as another variable such that its differentiation exists in the integral. So if you observe the given integrand, the derivative of log modulus of sin x, we will get cot x. Cot x is nothing but 1 by tan x. That 1 by tan x is there in the given integral. That's why I am considering the function log modulus of sin x as the new variable. So put log modulus of sin x is equal to t. Differentiate this one with respect to x. If you observe, left side part of function is log modulus of sin x. So sin x term, if you imagine as x, then the derivative of log x is 1 by x into derivative of x variable function, that is sin x derivative, we should write by using chain rule. That's why what we will get the new step? See here, 1 by sin x into d by dx of sin x is equal to dt by dx. Now what is the derivative of sin x? Cos x. So the next step is 1 by sin x into cos x is equal to dt by dx. 1 by sin x into cos x is nothing but cot x. So the next step is cot x is equal to dt by dx. Based on the trigonometric basics, cot x can be written as 1 by tan x. So the next step is 1 by tan x is equal to dt by dx. If we cross multiply, the next step is 1 by tan x into dx is equal to dt. Now, if we substitute this equation and this equation in the given integral, then what we will get? See here in the next step, integral t dt. Why? Because log modulus of sin x we considered as a new variable t, and 1 by tan x dx we got dt. That's why we got this new integral. If we observe this integral, it is clearly in the form of integral x power n dx. So we know the standard integral formula, integral x power n dx. By using this standard integral formula, what is the next step? See here, t square by 2 plus c. Now, replace the new variable by the original variable in the answer. So, what is the original variable function? Log modulus of sin x. So, in t place, if we substitute log modulus of sin x, then we will get the final answer. See, what is the final answer? 1 by 2 into log modulus of sin x whole square plus c. So, this is the final answer for the given integral. So, in this video, we discussed 4 important problems which are asked in previous board exams. I hope you understand. Thank you for watching.